800 meters freestyle, 16 lengths of the pool. It will take them something over 8 minutes to complete the race. Donna DeBarona, as an advocate of equal opportunity in women's athletics, do you believe the women should swim the 1500 meter freestyle?
I think a lot of them would like both, but if they had to choose, many of them would like to swim the 1500 meters. This is a good distance for women, and Australia has a great tradition in this particular event. In 1980, Michelle Ford won the event in Moscow. I'd like to point out, too, that in this event, they're all teenagers. I don't think it's a mistake.
It is an event dominated by young women. In fact, up in lane one, you have 13-year-old Monica Olmi of Italy. And in the middle of the pool, Hardcastle is 15 in lane three. Richardson is 15 in lane four. And the Australian contender, who ranked eighth in the world last year as a 14-year-old, is Anna McVan of Australia. She is in lane five. Michelle Ford of Australia won the gold medal in this event in Moscow 4 years ago. As they turn at 100 meters, the surprise leader is down in lane eight, Yolanda van der Meer, 19 years old from Holland, and also going out relatively rapidly toward the top of your screen is Tiffany Cohen of the United States, 18 years old from Mission Viejo, California. Tiffany Cohen has already won the gold medal in the 400 meter freestyle race here. She ranks number five on the all-time list in this event, second in the world last year to Astrid Strauss of the German Democratic Republic. Were Astrid Strauss here, she too would have been among the favorites to win medals, not necessarily, though, the hard and fast favorite to win the event.
Tiffany Cohen at the top of the screen went out in her first 100 of this race in a 101.86, relatively fast for her, 2 seconds faster than her preliminary heat time and only 6 tenths of a second off the American record set by Kim Linehan, who, by the way, is the world record holder in the 1500 meters. Under world record pace now, her time,
there it is,
205.27.
That's right. And so Tiffany Cohen, who went out relatively slowly in her qualifying heat and was obviously swimming just to qualify, is in lane two. Now, we've spoken often about the disadvantage of being in the outside lanes in the shorter races. In a long race like this, Donna, it is not such a disadvantage, is it?
Not really. And Tiffany does breathe on both sides, so she can see to her right and to her left. She has a typical distance freestyler stroke, two-beat kick. She tries to pick up her kick as she goes in and out of the turns. Breathes on both sides. When she breathes to the left, it's a little bit easier than breathing to the right. She kind of has a hitch in her coat, her stroke. You can see she picks up her head before she breathes to the right.
Tiffany Cohen, as I mentioned, 18 years old. Her mother got her started in swimming at age 8. Little did she know she'd come this far. With Ray Gandolf, let's meet her up close and personal.
It's 5:30 on a brisk and chilly morning. Time for Tiffany Cohen and the other inmates of the Swimmers Gulag in Mission Viejo, California, to go to work. The early hour may explain their kittenish approach to the job and Tiffany's reluctance to begin.
The hardest thing for me in a workout is just to dive in the pool. Sometimes I just don't want to dive in, and then once I'm in, everything's fine.
Once in, Tiffany hammers the water with the strength, if not the grace, of a golden dolphin. A three-time national champion in the 400-meter freestyle, she lifts weights and exercises daily outside the pool. She's intense, almost as intense as her coach, Mark Schubert.
I've always felt that Tiffany's been very highly motivated and she's wanted to succeed and she's been willing to push herself. I think if Tiffany can challenge the things that she's learned from swimming as far as setting goals and working hard towards goals, and once she achieves goals, resetting goals, she can channel those ideas into her future. I think that she'll be successful at whatever she does.
A spring graduate of Mission Viejo High School, Tiffany will go to the University of Texas in the fall on scholarship.
I'm really interested in psychology and sports psychology, and I think when I go to college, that'll be my major, and when I get out, I'd like to do something with psychology or sports psychology and maybe help other athletes.
Since the separation of her parents, Tiffany lives with her mother, Shirley, who was a competitive swimmer herself at a less exalted level.
Me and my mom, we're pretty close, and she always tries to help me in her best way that she can, like fixing meals, and like sometimes I don't have a chance to make my bed in the morning and little things, and she'll do that for me. I feel I'm pretty lucky to have such a dedicated parent, such a loving parent.
And so to bed, a Southern California small family version of the Waltons.
Good night, Mom. Good night, Tiff.
With less than 100 meters to go and still under world record pace.
That's right. She looks strong. She's been ready for this. And we said there were about four opportunities for world records in the women's swimming competition. I think she wants to be the first woman in this Olympics to break a world record.
That's right. No world record has been broken in the women's competition, although now eight of them have been broken by the men. Tiffany Cohen turns with 50 meters to go. She is in command of the race. Michelle Richardson, 15 years old from Miami, is in solid position to win the silver medal. Likewise, Hardcastle of Great Britain for the bronze. McVan does not appear in a position to challenge her. As Tiffany Cohen comes down toward the wall, she's picking it up, Donna.
She certainly is, and it's mostly she's relying on her arm. She's only used her kick going in and out of the turns. The crowd is up on their feet.
World record on the left of your screen, 8:24.62. She missed it just barely. 33 one-hundredths of a second, 8:24.95, and she looks a little disappointed by that. She was clearly gunning for it, but by more than 3 seconds, she has bettered her own personal best time.
And Tiffany Cohen wins the gold, Richardson the silver, Hardcastle the bronze. We will have more of today's...